Forever,
everything
you
you
have
have done,
done, you have done. Thank you,
thank
thank
you, thank you,
you,
Lord.
thank
you,
thank you, Lord,
Lord,
for
for
everything
everything
you have
you have
done.
done.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
Of this, we just thank you this hour, for you have brought us together once again, Lord King of Glory, to hear your word, O Lord. Let us be
Amen.
the hearer of your word and the doer of your word at the same time. Your name and your supreme name will be praised in our life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Lord King of Glory, we commit ourselves before you, Lord Jesus. Come and use the man, the woman that you will use, the woman of God that you are going to use today, Lord. Use her as your vessel of honor to your children to hear your word, O Lord King of Glory, in the wonder working name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Do that thing that you alone knows how to do in our life and in our destiny and in our home in the wonder working name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Lord King of Glory, give us a new inspiration, Lord King of Glory. We can be able to do this according to your commandment, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Baba, we thank you this day, because if we have mat all over our body, we can never thank you enough, O Lord. We thank you for the gift of life, O Lord, in the wonder working name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank
Amen.
You for the life of our family, Lord, in our ministry, Lord King of Glory. We thank you, Lord Jesus. You are
Amen.
The God of vengeance, O Lord King of Glory. Any Goliath that stand against the church, O Lord, Baba, come and bring that Goliath down in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
O Lord King of Glory, any Pharaoh, Lord Jesus, that stand against your church, because your word says, O Lord Jesus, the children of God, where they are marching on, the gate of hell shall not prevail against your children, Lord. Let the gate of hell never prevail against your church in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any Pharaoh in the life of all churches all over the whole world, O Lord King of Glory, Baba, Lord Jesus, let it draw down in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let there be a destruction in their coven, O Lord, in the wonder working name of Jesus.
Amen.
We commit the
rest
to your able hands, O Lord, take control, take authority, for in Jesus' mighty precious name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, amen. So now we're going to be looking at the word of God as usual, then we'll launch into prayers.
Amen.
Hallelujah. What does it mean, relationship in ministry? Relationship in ministry. Relationship in ministry. But before we open our Bibles, I want us to look into that word, the meaning of relationship. You like look at it, it's a compound word. When they say compound word in English, that's two words joined together to make one word. Two words brought together to make one word. So when you look at it, relation and then ship. Relationship. Two of them were brought together to give us that word, relationship. So we want to visit each of them individually, then we'll now bring them together. So let's start with relation first. Relation has to do with somebody close to you. Somebody close to you, somebody that influences your life one way or the other. And not only influences your life, you see, at the end of the day, you too, you affect that person's life one way or the other. You see, in life, even if it's somebody that do heaven and earth for you, one way or the other, you are still affecting that person's life. You know, there are things that rich people cannot actually do for themselves. Maybe the person is the one that lavish money on you, want, you know, anyhow. One way or the other, you still get the help when you go fix the help that person. I hear some people say, it's me and in the worker. That means they do everything. That means they do this one. And this one. And please, if you look into that statement very well, it's not totally true. It is not totally true. Why do I say so? You know, the other person might be offering minimal. Watch my words, minimal, very little. Is offering into that relationship. But then when you look at it very well, it's not totally out of that relationship. It's not just there offering anything, because any relationship, whether it's one-sided, that relationship don't always last. It doesn't always last. So you see that even when one is forward, one is investing everything, the other might not be investing much. It might just be little, but at the end of the day, you see that the other one is still investing something. So that was why I said that, well, the relationship you rub on one another, even whether it's husband and wife relationship, whether it's friend and friend to friend relationship, man between man, or no woman between to woman, you know, or daughter, you know, to father, anyhow, because we are here to affect one another. That is relation for you. Then let's look at the word sheep. Sheep, every sheep has a destiny. Every sheep has a destiny. The purpose of a sheep that was, every sheep that was made, it was never made so that a sheep be at a stagnant position. Each time a sheep is at a stagnant position, it stayed there just to, you know, to allow passengers in. Maybe the passengers come in and it's okay, they take off. Or maybe it breaks at an avo wherever it wants to refuel. You know, the purpose of every ship is meant to always be on the run. That is the purpose of it. It's just like a vehicle. When we pass our vehicle, not our cars, thank God we are that you are here now, God drives. When you pass, you just, when you bought that car, your initial intention of buying the car is don't go and park the car in the garage. It's the one park the car in the garage, you don't need it. We all bought our cars, or we had cars, maybe we're gifted back one where anywhere we have cars. The purpose of that vehicle is so that we can be, you know, we can be mobile. It can help us to move from one position to the other. So also ship is. Ship is not meant to be in one position, is to move. So when we come to join the two words together, relation and ship, at the end of the day, we come to the conclusion that any relation, anybody you are relating with, that will definitely end you up to a destination. Anybody you are relating with, both of you are heading to a destination, because every ship has its own destination. Either that destination, either it comes to mold you or it comes to break you. Every relationship is meant to be of such. Every relationship, either it makes you better or it makes you to become worse. It leaves you worse than it makes you. That is the truth about life. Have you not noticed, have you not observed concerning your life? The relationship you involved in, at the end of the day, you came to find out that relationship was not what you ever expected. You know, it made you worse. And you know, some of us, especially we women, I have seen most of us who can easily make friends, who can easily relate with this one, relate with this one, relate with this one. At the end of the day, we don't really get always get a positive result. For you to know that every relationship takes you to, you know, one destination or the other. So also, there are also positive relationships that you involve in. But when the relationship is on, you can easily, you know, easily pinpoint the positive things that came into your life as a result of that relationship. You can easily pinpoint, you know, how much progress you have been able to make. And when such relationship is like breaking, it's like you are crying, oh my God, this person, not that person is a God in your life, but you come to see that, this person must not just live my life. Because I know how God has used this person to affect my life, imparted my life in so much ways. So that, well, what we are saying tonight is that, you know, also in ministry, that is our goal to tell us, that is how whosoever we relate with affects us direct or indirectly. Many of us, our prayer life has become weakened because of wrong relationship. I don't know if that's happened to you. When you're into a relationship as a woman, you talk. You know, we women, let me not say women, some women, they love to talk. That's what at times they know women for. Except a woman can talk, but I don't know. I for one, I talk, but I don't talk too much. I don't know, not, you know, everyone cannot be like me. If I talk to one, I have headache. So that is why my relationship is very minimal. Yes, you call me on phone direct to the point, we talk and we finish, bye-bye. So don't say 1 hour for a phone. Me, I don't get time for that one, because each are like, today my head was heavy, yesterday my head was heavy. Or because like yesterday, I did a lot of counseling. At the end of the day, my head was just like aching. And even today, you know, I do that because I had this evening meeting. I had to just, you know, take some rest. No, before I will be able to gather myself together for this event. But am I not saying everybody will be like me? No, everyone cannot be like me. No, we all differ. Now I make up the way God makes us up. So all am I trying to say is that, you know, we have to be careful with who we relate ourselves to. Who we relate ourselves to. It matters to God. Either it helps you or it breaks you. our ministerial life, our every other aspect. Now, because I, you know, I try to title it concerning ministry because we all are ministers, female ministers on this platform. That is why that apply from ministry, even every aspect of our life, let's be careful who we relate to. They used to say that, well, show me your friend and I will tell you who you have. Why did they say so? Because they believe that your friend goes to say a lot about you. If you are not, we don't have something in common, we cannot relate. That is the truth. That's why the Bible said, Amos chapter 3, verse 3, can two work together except they agree? That's to say that what? Before we can work together, before we can have something in common, that means that what? There is agreement. There is agreement. There is that bond of unity. There is that relationship between us. So we have to be very, very careful. Many of us, we are where we are today. Not actually we are bad. Not actually the fault came for us. It's because as a result of wrong relationship, we mingle with those who are not supposed to mingle with. No wonder the Bible said, test us spirit. Test us spirit. Test us spirit. Yes, you see, for example, that like our ministry, I remember years ago, Dickiness Lover will remember. Okay, she might remember a few of them. I remember my husband and I, we used to run here and there. This church is doing program. This one is doing that. I'm not against we moving about. But we get to find out at the end of the day, is all minister spirit really the same with us? That is the truth. For the father says that, well, this one is a pastor's wife. This one is a dickiness. He's a dickiness like me. He's a pastor's wife like me. Do you know the spirit they carry? Yes, you have to be very, very careful who you involve with. It affects your life. It affects your destiny. So we are going, before I go ahead, we're going to be looking at the word of God tonight. Let's see the book of Jonah chapter 1. Let's look at Jonah chapter 1 from verse 1. You are there before me, please help me out. Jonah chapter 1. From verse 1, please. Okay, Jonah chapter 1 from verse 1. Are we there? If you are there, help me out. God bless you. Okay, guess we are now read. Jonah chapter 1, verse 1. I'm there to save time. Then now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa. And he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he fared afar thereof and went down into it to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the wind, so that the ship was like to be broken. Then the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God and cast forth the waves that were in the ship into the sea to lighten each of them. But Jonah was gone down into the side of the ship, and he lay and was asleep. What is happening here? God sent Jonah a message to go to a place to preach, Nineveh. And then Jonah disobeyed, and he went in another direction. Do you know there are people that we have involved ourselves in that have gone in another direction entirely from what God has sent them to do? And one way or the other, he affects us. I see people saying that anything the person do is not concern me. Who says so? Anybody with a relationship with it affects you. Even in good marriage, those of us that are married, we have come to discover anything your husband do, though we are female, yeah, okay, let's align to women. Anything your husband do, either he carries you ahead or he drags you back. Have you not noticed? Yes, anything your husband do, when your husband is on the positive side of life, you at the end of the day, you just go on. It affects you, it affects your home. But when a man makes mistakes, he affects their home also. He affects you as a woman. It brings a minus. So that is why relationship is very, very important. Look at Jonah. all these people that we are in, they were having their good time in the ship. The thief was going to attack you. But because Jonah disobeyed God, he went to involve himself in that ship that has a destination that he was going to. And at the end of the day, his disobedience and his presence into that ship made the ship to be heading to a wrong direction. May we not involve ourselves in the relationship that will end us in the wrong direction in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, many of us, we have lacked the blessings of God, not because of our errors or mistakes, but because of those we are involved with. Look at these people, because of time, we cannot really read this. If you look at Jonah chapter 1, if you read totally, you find that these people even lost their goose. Maybe some of them, they were business people, they're going to buy goose. Maybe that cost them a lot of money. And because the sea was troubled, because Jonah was involved with the ship was troubling here and there. And they didn't have choice. They thought maybe the ship was overweight. They began to throw away their goods. Imagine what they have labored for with hard-earned money. They began to throw it so that the ship can be calm. For where some of us, they are things in our lives that today we say, this one not being this one now. Not knowing that it's the relationship we have involved ourselves in. Not knowing that it's the relationship we have involved ourselves in. I pause here to say, who are you reporting your husband's issue to? Who are you reporting your children's issues to? Who are you reporting your own personal issues to? It matters, my dear. You know, at times you make the mistake. We just think that I want to hear my heart. I want to pour out my heart because my heart is heavy. You know, as we women, in the midst of that, please be careful who you discuss your matter with. Be very, very careful. It's important. At times, these people, they don't have negative influence over us or negative intention. But you'll be discovered what you say. The next time you hear that word, where you go and hear your word, now far, far place. And the way they will so turn the word, the way they will ask sugar and maggi, you'll be shocked and say, I can't believe this is not how I told this person. So am I not saying now that we should just stay alone without relating to anybody? No, that is not my message tonight. My message tonight, we're going to look deeper into the word of God. We are just coming, God bless you. We are looking at relationship in ministry. Relationship in ministry. And we are going to break it down into those two words. Relationship has to do with two. Relating and what? Relation and ship. So every ship has a destiny. Every relationship has to do with, every relation has to do with we affecting one another. So back to what I was saying, where I stopped. Are we not saying that we should just stay alone? It is not possible. You cannot stay alone. You cannot do the work alone. You need somebody by your side. Even we look at the life of Jesus, our perfect example. Jesus never did the work alone. That was why he had the 12 disciples. Because we must know in life there is no perfect person. If we are not looking for somebody perfect, we can accept into our lives. We will not have one till we come to the point of death. Because come to think of it also, our own lives, we are not perfect. I am not perfect. You are not perfect. But all I'm trying to say tonight, we need to be careful. And let's be led by the Spirit. People will really bring into the core of our lives. I read something. Somebody wrote something. And where did the thing go? He said, accept everybody at the table of your life. The table of your life, accept everybody. He said, but be careful who you give a seat to sit on that table. Accept everybody on the table of your life. Say, but be careful who you give a seat to sit down on that table. What is he trying to say? The person you really bring close, you have to be very, very careful about it. Look at Jesus' life. Jesus had three different kinds of relationship. Number one, the one ahead of him. Those ahead of him. So if we must succeed in ministry, there must be people we look up to. I hear some people and say that I'm just on my own. I have nobody. Jesus is my perfect example. Yes, like Jesus, he has God the Father. He has a God the Father that is looked up to for everything. But at the same time, we must know that we are trying to be like Jesus. We are not yet Jesus. We need other people that have been in this world more than us. One we can relate to, one we can learn from. What we can copy from. That was why the Bible said, iron sharpens iron. So a man sharpens the countenance of his friend. But may I make you to know this evening, when we talk about iron sharpens iron, it is, if you look at iron, when you bring iron together, most of the times the one that is sharp, is needed to sharpen the weak one. You need, it's like a battery. When you drive your car, when your battery is weak, and you just need a car that the battery is strong. You know that thing to transfer power to your own battery, and it picks up. So also we need people that have been ahead of us. One we can fall back on. Those that we can relate issues to, they are very, very important. There are another set of people we need is those that are contemporaries. That's those that are equal with us. Those that are equal with us. Jesus as such also, like John the Baptist. John the Baptist in the ministry. If you look at it very well, in the book of John chapter 1, the Bible says some of John the Baptist, they turned out to become John the Baptist disciples. They turned out to become Jesus' disciples. For example, like Andrew, he was once John the Baptist's disciple before he became Jesus' disciple at the end of the day. So we need people that are equal with us in ministry. We can still relate to, even not an ordinary marital life and other issues. And also, finally, we need those that we are ahead of. We need those ahead of us. You know, no matter how you think you are, there are still people that are looking up to you. In your marriage, there are people that see eye in you. In that business, there are people that see eye in you. In the ministry, people are still wishing, if I can be like this mama, if I can learn something, when this mama sings, she sings very well. When this mama leads prayer, she leads prayer very well. If I can be like that. So you will see that we need these three group of people in our lives. If we must, because God does not condemn. God sets you ahead so that he can bring others along, so that these other ones, they will look up to you. We are the true representative of Christ, especially we in the ministry. No wonder the Bible said, let our light so shine, so that men will see our good works and glorify God, which is in heaven. And I see God glorified in our lives and in our ministries in the name of Jesus. Praise Amen. The Lord. Hallelujah. And I'm believing that, you know, this group will take us somewhere. Apart from coming to share the word of God, I want to actually, I'm believing God, other people bring into it. But I don't just want to do things on my own. I don't just want to jump up and today I will introduce this one. And let's go, my people, my women, let's do this one. Tomorrow, do this one. You know, anything that is not of God does not stand. So I'm still believing God for directions. Apart from sharing the word of God, coming to pray, let's look at all, I still believe in other things we can bring into this group that will make it colorful. And God will help us to do so in the name of Jesus. And one day you can also be called. I believe as I have experience, so also you have experience also. Maybe one or two things you will impact us with. Apart from ministry, our marriages are there. Our homes are there. Some of us even have children older than mine. So you might have knowledge in that children more than mine that you see share that will be of benefit to every one of us. Amen. Praise the Lord. We are going to pray this evening. We want to pray. We have heard the word of God. Every relationship has a destination. Every relationship has a destination. And I want to advise us. People will be seriously close to our life. Let them be few. You can add many friends. There can be many. But the one that you really call the inner carcass that comes in, let them, if you can just be one or two bastards, it's okay like that. When it's too much, it's problem. I am telling you the truth. When it's too much, it's problem. Yes, others are not saying we make enemies. No, we don't have enemies as Christian women, as women in ministry, women that fear God. But then we have to be very careful who we really pick. That said, this one at my home, this one at the top heaven I air to. It is very, very, it matters a lot. How can you have a friend and you say, it's time, my friend, this matter, let's take it to God in prayer. She is not interested. Anytime you mention prayer, she doesn't want to be involved. You say, let's try, doesn't want to. That goes to tell you, that person, there is a level of relationship, you will not be involved with that person. He ought not to be your close friend. No, your friend that you really call your friend, your closest one must be able to go the direction you are going. Must be able to go the direction you are going. If it is not, one way or the other, we drag you back. We will drag you back. May we not be dragged back in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Unto the Lord be the glory. Unto the Lord God be the glory, great is He as God. Unto the Lord be the glory, great is He as God. Great is He as God. Unto the Lord be the glory, great is He as God. Let's give him thanks. Let's exalt him. Let's thank him. Let's give him praise. Let's thank him. Let's thank him for who he is. Let's worship him. Ramali Habakosenda. Ragada gada 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 gada. For whom we have wondered. For whom we have wondered. Be that glorified. Be that exalted. Be that magnified. Hallowed be your holy name. Glory to your holy name. We adore you. We celebrate you. Eternal of our ages. We give you praise for our lives. God has many ministry. Lord God, many are not your opportunity. Many just want God for wishing for one day they handle this Bible to reach your fathers, but they have not been given the privilege. Here we are, Lord God, think of your God, Lord God, from the most good. Father, chosen, prepared to God by you. That is who want to say, sign for you. Bless not our heroes, our mystery of God, think of glory. Father, you still so, Lord God, you chose to recognize them from us. Here we are, Lord God, showing appreciation. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We give a praise for such a member. Bless you in your name. Pray not be exalted. Pray not be glorified. Pray not be exalted. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Jesus' name we have given thanks.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Before I lift a raise prayer point, I want us, we all are going to give prayer point. Amen. Hallelujah. While we wait for others to come along, though time is fast spent. Amen. We ask, Sister Awogo, please give us your prayer points, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, everyone.
Amen. Please, we can't hear you well, ma'am.
Good evening, everyone.
The volume is spent.
Hey, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I can hear her. Me, I can hear her.
Mommy, can you hear me now?
Are you all here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Dickiness, now can you hear her, ma?
Yes, I can hear her.
Okay, they said they can hear you. Carry on, carry on.
Okay, ma, thank you very much, ma. We'll be praying according to Psalm 133, verse 1. The Bible said, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. So tonight, it said in Amos 3:3, say, can two walk together except they agree? For us to be able to take our ministry to the next level, we need unity among the leadership in our various churches, in our various groups. The Bible said a house that divided himself cannot stand. In the dark world, they are so united, but in the kingdom, the church, we are envy here and there, this unity, disagreement in our midst. So tonight we are going to be praying that God should release upon every churches the spirit of oneness, of unity, that will be speaking one voice. It is only in one voice, in oneness, we can be able to turn the world. So let's lift up our voice tonight. Let's begin to pray for the spirit of oneness in our various churches, the spirit In Lord God, in our
Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our Lord, in our
Victorious name, we are praying.
What God, the vision of that ministry is saying, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We ask, man, the Kinesina, please give us your prayer points, man.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, ma, for the opportunity. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. This hour, we are going to pray for our various churches, because most especially here in the Europe, you can see the churches nowadays, they are still afraid. Many people are still at home. They don't used to come to church anymore just because of the pandemic, and they normally go and do their various things, their daily basis outside. But when it comes to the time to come to the church, they find it difficult. And we are going to pray that anything that the devil is using to deviate our members away from the house of the Lord, that the Lord Almighty will put it to shame in the mighty name of Jesus.
Let us pray. Let them begin to see the reason to serve you. Let them begin to see the reason to serve you. For to live for you. By the Lord be your Sunday service, the Lord God, your King of the just coming to church. But if every man has a personal relationship with you, no other man need to push him or her to come around. My God, Lord, we just feel as our father's prayers. For Jesus' sake, don't you know I have to be at my father's prayers? Let us begin to see at that individual. I don't go this way, I will go next week. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this way, I will go next way. If I'm not present in this, there's a lot of God that begin to turn on the same. Let them begin to see that God is a person of the Trinity. If I don't go this
Amen. We are going to pray according to the exhortation tonight. We are going to be using taking our prayer point from the book of Genesis chapter 11, the Tower of Babel. So we are going to be praying. I'm going to be taking my prayer point from verse 7 of it. See, go to, let us go down. This is God speaking. Now let us go down and yeah, confirm their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So we are going to pray. Every negative tongue, every negative voice against the ministry, against the work of God, tonight may the Lord come down from heaven and scatter their tongue and destroy their tongue in the mighty name of Jesus. Confuse their language in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's need to open our mouth.
We should ask for that germ of a feed. Thank you, Lord God, tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask for prayer tonight. Let heaven open. Hear us tonight, Lord. Hear us tonight, Lord. Hear us tonight, Lord. Let heaven turning around. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Please, ma'am, Pastor Mrs. Lanker, please give us your prayer points, ma'am.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good evening, Mama. Good evening,
God
Ma.
Bless you, Ma. God bless you,
yes,
Ma. You're
thank
welcome.
You for
you're
this
welcome.
Opportunity, Ma. Thank you for the opportunity, Ma.
Amen.
Yes,
amen.
Ma. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want us to pray that God should empower our men of God and God should continue to strengthen them.
Amen.
That God should build their God and it should be their power, that the word of God will not suffer in their hand. That's my prayer point.
Amen. Please, let's open our mouth and pray. Hey, God should empower our men of God, our men and women of God, those that deliver the word. The word will not suffer in our hands. Our hands, the word will not collapse. Rather, we need to destroy it. Amen. Fresh oil, fresh oil. Father, we pray for Lord God, the Lord God, the Lord God, the Lord Lord, the 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 Lord,
In the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are still praying. Please, Evan Spitz, please, man, give us your prayer point.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Please, I'm very sorry, man, for coming late.
We are going to pay due for that.
Okay. I'm very sorry, man. Please, we are going to pray. Although I was not here for the exhortation, but we are going to pray. There is this man. I'm still reading about this man. He was is a very close herdsman to King Saul. He was the one always reporting David to Saul. So anywhere he see David, he will go and report to Saul. His name is Doeg. So we are going to pray.
Okay,
that also in the book of 1 Samuel, we are going to pray that whosoever, that every conspiracy against our men of God, against for them to renounce, for them to say they are not going to serve God again, for them, because they are preparing, there is this conspiracy, they always conspire together against men of God. You will see great men of God today, some will say, no, I don't have a church anymore, I'm going to close down this church. Why? Because they have seen something bigger than them. We are going to pray that whosoever that is conspiring against our men of God, that is conspiring the women of God, those that are ready to serve God, to make them to deny God, we are going to pray, let the fire of the Holy Ghost, the thunder of the Holy Ghost, let anyone monitoring them for evil, anyone monitoring them for destruction, let the fire of the Holy Ghost locate them by fire, by thunder of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray, let us pray. Fighting them in every way to make them deny God. I begin to pray now. All you evil monetary demon, monetary dead. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost, let the thunder of the Holy Ghost get you by fire, by fire. In the name of Jesus, reconspiracy, sorry for evil, Holy Ghost fire. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. All your plans, all your evil agenda against the powerful men of God, against the men of God, against the woman of God, it shall not stand in the name of Jesus. In Jesus, unchallengeable name, we pray.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, because God, the Bible says, smite the shepherd, the sheep with scatter, smite the shepherd, the sheep with scatter. That is to say, Lord God, King of glory, that oil flows from the head, whereby Lord God, the oil is no longer present on the head. Father, the body suffers. God send the book of Psalm 133, and good and happy is the seed for bread to dwell together. It's like Lord God, the oil that flows, Lord God, from the head, it's off the head, so the beer, Lord God, from the head. My God, I pray, every form of distractions, that so that Lord God, the oil will no longer be
I come against the name of Jesus Christ. And Pastor God, but we not be shepherd that sleep not the night. The Bible says the King of them, the shepherd, the God wash over their sheep by night. Luke chapter 2, not the King of them, that was when the angels came for another person, and there were great rejoicing. They have not got be asleep, not God, the wood of God, the years. My God, I would have sheepish everything. Those under us, the King of them, my God, the God, that's God, I discuss them and my husband. And every minister here on this platform tonight, fresh shield of God, every man and women who are called. Lord, the Bible says we should stand in the gap. Lord, God, those that are weak in this morning, I encourage straight in order. I encourage straight in order. I encourage straight in order. Ramasita, this walk will not die in our hands. This walk will not die in our hands. That jewel will not give up. All that will be raised up. All that will be raised up. Where speak that matter that is going. Arise and be the king. It is not over the people. It is not over the people. Looking up to Jesus.
You are welcome, ma. Please give us your prayer points, ma.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm sorry for coming late. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to pay against anything that will bring shame, that will bring reproach to the body of Christ. We are going to come against them and say, Father, whatever that will bring shame, whatever that we bring reproach to the body of Christ, we come against you last night in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Let's begin to pray. Amen. Let's turn into prayer. Every shame, every reproach, every shame, every reproach, the body of Christ. Let's begin to cancel. Let's begin to cancel.
Lord, whatever that will bring shame and reproach, oh Lord,
every error,
oh Lord, Lord, we come against you. Lord, we come against you, oh Lord, Father. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Let us come against the body of Christ.
It is not the portion of all God in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, we celebrate the Lord. Thank you, the God of opportunities. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Any prayer requests? Now the prayer point we need to pray over, or anything we need to thank God. We want us to join you to thank God over something God has done in your life. Please, the floor is open to speak so that we pay attention to it before we call it a day tonight.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. I want us to pray for the sick one among us, because the Bible makes us to understand the book of James. Is anyone sick among you? He said, let it call for the elders of the church and pray. Because somebody that is sick, you know, when I say sickness, it's not just ordinary sickness that maybe you just have ordinary headache. You can be able to take a swallow, a paracetamol, and come and stick onto the prayer group. So there are some sickness that one will be fighting that means you are not able to join the prayer group. So anyone that is sick among us, we are going to pray that the enemy have been afflicted in any kind of sickness. We are going to join our faith together tonight to meet the sickness in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Let's pray.
Amen.
Sickness is not our portion.
Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are calling today. Amen. Because of our time. Any other prayer point, just take one, then we'll round up tonight. And we'll round up by 7. Okay. In the absence of none, we're going to be rounding up. But before we round up, we're supposed to have a discussion today, but because I saw that most of us, we are not online on time. So it wouldn't be wise whereby 2 or 3 people we're going out to discuss an issue that has to do with, I think we are 10 in number now in this group. So that was why I was just trying to to see how we can come up time. But today that will no longer be possible. Please, I want to beg all of us, next week, Thursday, there are issues we need to attend to on this platform. I'm pleading next week, Thursday, let's be around every one of us and also on time. Please, we need your time. It's very, very important. It's just an hour. I understand most of all we work. We are busy. But in the midst of your busy schedule, please. So that you can do this work well. And the Englishman says anything worth doing is worth doing well. God bless us. Please, let's go and mark it next week, Thursday. We have some things we need to, discuss over. God will bless us in Jesus' name. So we'll round it up in prayers tonight. We accept. Oh, before we round up, somebody has to say.
Mommy, you said something about the fasting. So because we're not much the other time, so you said we are going to...
Yes, man. That was what I referred to. I was trying to talk about just now that, we have discussed about, because, people didn't turn up on time on the platform. Okay. So I'm shifting it to next week.
All right.
So because I, for one, don't like exceeding time. We are all busy. There are even some that after this meeting now that will be going to work. Some people are in their shops now, like Pastor Mrs. Lanke, I believe. Mommy, I think you are in the shop.
Yes,
he's in the shop. Yes, he's operating from my shop now. Hey, please forgive me of my women. Children, what have almost escaped me. Please, let's with a clap offering, let's celebrate our mommy on the platform.
God bless you, ma'am. Praise the Lord. God bless you, ma'am. He's our first time coming with us.
You're welcome, ma'am.
How did you see the meeting, ma'am? You enjoyed it.
Yes,
fine. Everything is fine.
So we hope to be seeing more of you, more and more. Hey, okay. One thing I love about this Zoom meeting, you can connect everywhere, even in the bus, station, anywhere you can connect. So please, man, you're welcome. And invite others also. Every one of us on this platform, invite other women of God, women leader, whatsoever. You know, just they have been ordained into ministry. Invite them. Pastor's wife, deaconess, or invite them. Let's come and pray together. You know, say we women get where will they do our thing? What will they do? And I'm just told the women they do their thing. Amen. God will help us in Jesus' name. So I tell God, you understand me, man.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you for reminding me. Not actually for
it's Sister Faith, it's Evangelist Faith that remind you today, not me today.
Okay. It was even Evangelist Faith that reminded you. That's good. That's why we are there for one another. So please, next week we have to discuss that. And every other point you might have in your mind, come with it. Let's reason together. God, you know that we know, take this platform to another greater level. God bless you all in Jesus' name.
Thank you, ma'am.
So amen. We are any other thing, one or two things, quickly look to before call it a day.
Sorry, ma'am. Let me shift in something before we call it a day. So maybe next week on Thursday, we can be able to pray and finish like 7:40 so that we have the 20 minutes to discuss and conclude what we want to do. Those that want to come up with the ideas or the conclusion so that we'll have time. If we want to say, let's finish prayer, we'll still not have time. We have to exceed the time and enter other hours. So I say, let me just...
That's nice. I think even 7:30, I think 7:30 will even be better because 20 minutes might not be enough. Yeah. 30 minutes should be enough for us. Next week, we might not actually share the word. Maybe we'll go straight into prayers. We can just give two or three people, if there's everyone on give prayer point, back. Then we'll launch into our discussion. Thank you for that great wisdom. God bless you. Amen. So we're going to be praying. Amen. We ask, Deaconess Edosa, please, ma, round it up for us in prayers, ma.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Days we just thank you this hour, Lord King of Glory. Beside you, there is no one in our life, oh Lord.
Amen.
Baba, it is you we trust, it is you we hope, it is you we depend, oh Lord Jesus. Baba, amen. As we have connected with this group, oh Lord King of Glory, give us the spirit of unity, let it dwell among us in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Raise your banner for people to see, Lord King of Glory, that we glorify you that is in heaven in our life, Lord King of Glory, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we are living this prayer, this hour, Lord Jesus, we are not leaving your presence. Oh Lord, let your presence go before us and go before us in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your will be done in our life in the mighty name of Jesus. When this opportunity is given, oh Lord Jesus, let us have more to say, Lord King of Glory, and more to discuss, oh Lord Jesus, and more to pray about in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
New vision, Lord King of Glory, that we raise the banner of your heaven name in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you. We give you praise. We give you the adoration.
Amen.
We soak these women in ministry with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Well, Lord King of Glory, we soak with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Amen. Jesus, mighty precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's share the grace. May the grace of
the Lord Christ,
the love of God, and the sweet Lord of the Lord, rest and abide with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
God bless you all. Thank you for making yourself available.
God bless you.
God bless you. Next week, have a wonderful service. Amen. Regards to the family.
Amen. Thank you very much.